sit down. Again, start off with a chord progression to kind of work with in a general direction. And so if it's a 2-5-1, again, it might start off on C minor 7. Maybe move up into a different position. And just by playing a different inversion, have a new color. Here I have an F7, maybe a flat 9, a little tension. All 2-5-1s, but just moving through inversions. I believe that, especially when it comes to noodling and improvisation, it's kind of this unnatural naturalness that we're developing. And for me, when noodling or improvising, even if it's just kind of for fun on the side, I feel like that it's really important to, again, at the core of it, keep the emotional content there. And if we're kind of troubled with particular scales of whatnot or the form, then it can be a little bit tricky to kind of work through because then we're thinking of another thing. And so I believe that in practice, behind the curtain, so to say, we do these kind of rigid things. And of course, we can go through diatonic harmony. So if you're doing a C minor 7 in the key of B flat, you can do a kind of a C Dorian or et cetera, et cetera. F Mixolydian over here. But again, through all that practice and conditioning, you can hear what you want to play, opposed to just playing patterns or copying something. And if you keep, I feel like, if you play what you hear, then I feel like it comes a little bit more naturally, and in a sense, a little more musical. Scales, for sure, are a great place to start. And I know it's kind of almost an easy answer to that, but when you're working with scales, the way I like to look at it, if you think of it from like a language point of view, I mean, this is basically like learning letters. I mean, it really. And having, assigning and knowing what a C sounds like, almost knowing what an A sounds like, and maybe even more particular, what they sound like, not against each other, but next to each other, you know? Understanding intervals and things like that, I think really make it a little bit easier to kind of convey what you're hearing. Now, that being said too, practicing scales, and I feel like vocalizing them can be really important because, again, you know, this is our first instrument that we begin to play, whether we like it or not. And so even if you take something simple like a C major scale, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Now, without the ukulele, I can take C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, or even just the melody notes themselves. And again, now if I want C, D, E, or something else, you know, then I can move around in that. And again, it comes from here opposed to just a pattern. My first exploration into kind of modal music in general was Miles Davis and Kind of Blue. And so things like So What, tunes like that, have really impacted me, I feel like. And so I think from that, I just love playing Dorian, you know? I feel like it is like a good kind of happy place, so to say, between major and minor with some of the degrees, you know, and it's just a fun mode to play with, I feel like. It's basically going to start off on the 2, right? So if I'm going to do a D Dorian, that's basically going to be D to D, no sharps and flats. So I'm doing a...